Based on the response to our last video about HRV and HRV status, you all had a lot of good questions, and we're going to try to answer some of those today. Starting with, can I compare my HRV to someone else? Comparing your HRV to someone else really doesn't give you anything meaningful because HRV, or your heart rate variability, is such a personalized metric, and there are a lot of factors that can impact your HRV, that what is good, normal for one person can be totally different for another person. And just because one person's HRV is higher or lower than yours doesn't mean that one is better or worse. Most important and most meaningful is to look at how your HRV compares to your own personal baseline range. What can you take away from having a balanced HRV status? A balanced status tells you that your body is in what we'd call homeostasis. So you have a good balance of stress and recovery. So when you're in this balanced state, that's a good sign that your body is relaxed and well adapted to any stressors that you're putting on it. And especially for training, that can be really useful to know, as that can help in terms of improving your adaptation to training as you're looking to improve and maybe increase your workload. How does HRV relate to exercise? Well, there's a couple ways that you can use HRV in relation to your exercise. One, heart rate variability can be used to inform your training. Heart rate variability is a good indicator of how your body is adapting to the demands of training, especially if you're increasing your workload. Seeing that your heart rate variability is balanced, which means that it's staying within your personal baseline range, is a good indication that your body is adapting well to the demands of exercise, and that you are getting enough recovery in between workloads. If you see that you're starting to move into unbalanced, that might be a sign that you're increasing your training too much and maybe need to back off a little bit to give your body more time to recover. Does a high HRV equal good and a low HRV equal bad? Generally speaking, HRV trending up or trending upward is a good thing, but again, HRV is a highly personalized metric and is influenced by a lot of different factors. So probably the best question to ask is, what is a good HRV score for me? And most important to look at is your personal baseline. That's what you build up over 3 weeks of wearing the watch to sleep. And you can look at your 7-day average HRV compared to your personal baseline and know that if you're within your baseline, that's a good score for you. When is HRV measured? We measure HRV, or your heart rate variability, while you sleep. This gives us the most reliable measurement to use to build up trends over time. So each night you'll get an overnight graph of your HRV, and then over a 7-day period we'll build up your 7-day average HRV, and then over a 3-week period or more we build up your personal baseline range. And then once we have the personal baseline range, we're able to compare your 7-day average to your personal baseline and determine if your HRV status is balanced. How important is sleep to my HRV status? Sleep is critical to HRV status for a couple reasons. For one, we measure HRV during sleep to get the most reliable measurement that can be used to compare trends over time. So without wearing the watch to sleep, you aren't going to get your HRV or HRV status. Two, sleep is really a really important factor in terms of helping your body get recovery, and so getting good sleep and good sleep quality can help improve your HRV and keep your HRV balanced. What variables could cause my HRV status to become unbalanced or low? Several factors can impact your HRV and HRV status. These could include things like physical activity, stress, sleep and sleep quality, nutrition and diet, and even alcohol. If you see that your HRV status is unbalanced or low and is below your personal baseline range, any of those factors could be contributing to that decrease in HRV. If you see that your HRV status is unbalanced but above your personal baseline range, that could be a sign that you maybe have ramped up your training significantly recently. If you are in, let's say, an overload period, your body may actually be struggling to recover. And seeing that high HRV can be a sign that you also are needing more recovery and maybe extra fatigue from that higher workload. What are some options to make my HRV status balanced again? First thing would be to think about what might be the cause of your HRV status getting unbalanced or low in the first place, as lots of different factors can impact your HRV. So you might look at things like your sleep and sleep quality, your amount of exercise and physical activity, your nutrition, and even alcohol, and figure out of those what might be the contributing factor or factors, and then look at making changes there. And keep in mind too that HRV status is looking at long-term trends, so it might take, you know, a few days or a week before you start to see that HRV status change from unbalanced back into balanced.